Balling on the, how about I say, Balling on the Budget. It's your boy Frank Nady back in the building, back in the sneaker room, back bringing you guys another video. Today, we're going to talk about some sneakers that dropped on the sneaker app a couple days ago. I'm not sure if a lot of you guys hit. It was very sporadic in the sense of how it worked. Like, there's no rhyme or reason. I don't get what's going on with Nike. I don't know because shoes are not selling out, given this artificial sold out, because I got a lot of not selected, but then a couple hours later, they were readily available. You can pick any size you wanted. And that's the consensus that I'm getting recently. It happened with those the Rip Hamiltons that dropped not too long ago, those Jordan 14s. Remember they sold out, and then I know it was a restock in a sense, but it was a lot of not selected going on, and then it just randomly appeared. It happened to the PGs, the Paul George, Mama Mentalities, and it happened with the Kyries as well. I got screenshots. Not selected. So I don't know what's going on. Please explain, Nike, what is going on with your sneaker app? But anyways, man, enough about that. Let's talk about the shoes that I actually got, even though I was not selected, but eventually I was able to purchase a few hours later, man. So first up to deck, let's talk about these joints. And here we have it, the On Air collection. But before I continue, man, old dog, old habits. I am not in the sneaker room. I'm actually on my couch. So please forgive. We're gonna come up with a name when I get my sneaker room taken care of. It's upstairs, it's still in shambles. So forgive me, we'll find a name and I'll get y'all in the buildings. Y'all can see what the new spot looks like. But anyways, man, we got the On Air collection. Like I said, I didn't cop this my first attempt was unsuccessful, bro. It was like an air ball. I shot, I missed, not selected. I didn't even get picked. I tried for a team to cut me. But then I tried again and I got it. And I got the Air Max. I got a little message here. I hope when you wear these shoes, it feels like you have a little piece of NY with you. Remember to walk with love and your heart for all people. So she a Leo. Take after my heart, man. I'm also a Leo. Birthday's in August, coming up here shortly. But anyways, man, here is the shoes. You got the wax paper and it's multiple cities and countries. You got Seoul, you got New York, you got London, you got Paris, and NY. Tokyo on here. I want to say I saw Tokyo. Probably is Tokyo. It says T-Y-O. And here they go, y'all. These are the Air Max NYCs. This was actually created by Gabrielle Serrano, created these joints. And she had a lot of different inspiration through the whole shoe. The mud guard right here is supposed to be a reflection of the dirt and grime of New York. I don't know. I'm just making that part up. But anyways, what I do know is that the swoosh, that little lime green or neon green, is supposed to represent Statue of Liberty along with the laces. The multiple different hues that you see on the upper represent different skin tone for the people in NYC. And if you're from NY, you know it's a concrete jungle, and that's what this actually represents, man. It represents cement and concrete. That's what New York is, bro. It's a concrete jungle. If you haven't been there, do visit. It's definitely a life experience. I grew up there in Brooklyn for years till I moved to Florida, but I do go back frequently, at least once a year. I used to go twice, but I go once a year, and I no longer go in the winter because it's harsh. I'm a fan of 98s. I told y'all it's probably up there as my number one or two. Depends on which day you hit me up, man. Hey, 98s are dope, bro. They are dope. Got a little patchwork right here, what I call the little patch pattern, which separates the difference between the 97 and the 98, because they got the same outsole, same tooling for the outsole, full length Air Max unit, definitely visible on the lateral and medial side of the shoe. Also got that blue hue inside the air bubble, you can see. It's completely clear and vivid. Also, a little bit of hit of white. Does say Nike on the insole, and it is blue and green. Man, dope shoe, man. Gabby, appreciate for making this shoe. Now, there were six total competitors, and every city got one individual to represent their city, and she's representing New York. I'm not sure how old she is. She is Hispanic. They actually call this La Mezcla. La Mezcla, I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Probably not. But in English, it means mixture, and that's what you see here. It's a mixture of different reasonings behind this shoe. Now, you do have the longitude and latitude. I haven't looked that up. It does say it's in, with a bunch of numbers, and it says W with a whole bunch of numbers. If you guys took geography, you already know those numbers represent latitude and longitude, and it would be crazy if I'm actually wrong on the patchwork right here. So I'm actually going to Google those longitude and latitudes to see what that will represent, because I am not clear on what that could be at the moment. But these are size 12, my size. And give me a minute, let me take a look. So this latitude and longitude represent 1556 Broadway, New York. Broadway, New York can be found in Manhattan, the borough of Manhattan. I'm not sure if that's considered Midtown. I'm not good on general directions as that. If it's southeast, northwest, middle, south, whatever the case is. But this represents Broadway. Now, Broadway, we all know, is that's where you see a lot of like plays. If you ever remember Cats, Cats was a long historic play that ran for years. Now they have Hamilton. You could find that at Broadway. You guys get the message, right? What I like about these shoes that when people design them, man, they kind of take their own personal experience and they kind of cement that into the shoe. What they're going through at that moment or what their life has been in the past, they reflect that on the design. And this is what her design is. This is what Gabby reflects. Being from New York, I can see that. My concept would be similar. Concrete jungle. Now, my experiences differ because I grew up in the 80s, early 90s in New York. And, you know, crack was crazy back then. So I would have a different outcome. Now, Brooklyn, it is gentrified. So you have a lot of mixture in between. And it definitely wasn't the harsh, watch your back, gang related, crack violence atmosphere what you used to, man. New York has changed tremendously since I grew up there to now and present. So every person will have their own upbringing and they'll reflect that in the shoe. Silhouette is dope, my personal opinion. I think she nailed it. I like her concepts a lot. I'm not sure what else I can go over on the shoe. I'll show you the second shoe, the right shoe. And here's the second shoe. Now, what's noticeably different is the shoelace. She got that blue shoelace, man, represent the water, man. I think that's what the Aero units are for, too. It's represent the water, the green Statue of Liberty. Boom, you still got the different skin tones, as you can take it from all different origin and descents. It's like a melting pot in New York, man. Melting pot to the black, Nigerian, African descents, West Indian, Chinese, Europeans, Russians. Hit every seven continents, man. You'll find it in New York, bro. You'll find it in New York. And these are dope, man. I love this piece. Now, did they retail for $200? I know that's smacking a lot of you guys in the face. Shit, it smacked me in the face. $200 for these shoes, man. But when you're so used to buying Jordans, and it's been a while since I bought some Jordans that I actually like, plus I've been saving some money on some shoes recently, it wasn't as hard to fork over some cash. You already know how Nike do. If it's a collab, if it's limited, you know, saying that price hike is coming, man. So I was able to get these shoes off the sneaker app, and now I have them in my possession. Let me know if you guys cop, man, of the six pairs that's dropped. I know there was a 270s, there was the Air Max 1, there was 298. I want to say there was a 97 as well, and 270, 298, oh, one Air Max 1, 197. Am I missing one? I gotta be missing one, because I thought it was six. Let me know down below which one I'm missing. I can't think of the top of my head right now. Wow. I stand corrected. It was actually 397s, 198, one Air Max 1, and one 270. But anyways, man, let me know if you guys like this video. Be patient. I am trying to find a way how I can make my videos pop. I know the lighting in here is great. If I go and watch the Warrior game, I know I'm a couple days behind. They got spanked. How you lose a 31-point lead? And that Boogie's out. KD only, what, he was 5-8 from the field, I heard. That's what the gossip is, so I gotta see for myself. I wanna see how they blew this 31-point lead. But anyways, man, I appreciate you guys for pulling up, rocking with your boy. Yo, we hit 20,000 subscribers, man, because of y'all. Bless. Miss Miyagi Bow again. Thank you. I got a lot of the shoes I'm gonna review. I'm gonna get them out, and I hope you guys enjoy the content. Nike videos are still coming. I'm gonna hit y'all in the head with those. Other than that, man, that's pretty much it. Appreciate you guys for showing up. If you're new to this channel, you like what you just saw, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, that notification bell as well. Everyone else, keep leaving those comments down below, and your boy get back to you as soon as possible. Until then, until we meet again, until I'm in front of this lens and in front of your screen, you already know my slogan. Good to go. It's a wrap.